Well, we also have new economic data out this morning. GDP was unrevised in the third quarter, coming in at a 2.1% annualized rate. Now, this comes after consumer spending ticked higher last month, rising 0.4%. We also have personal income, which was up 0.5%. Joining us now is Joseph Minarik. He's former chief economist at the OMB under Clinton and a senior vice president of research at the Conference Board. And Joseph, when you take a look at the market highs once again, it seems like there's nothing that can stop this market's momentum. Do you see this continuing into 2020?
Well, what we have now in terms of recent news that's important is a dialing down of the tensions over the trade relationship between the United States and China, which was a very important factor. Plus, we have the close to an agreement on the USMCA trade agreement. Those two things are very positive, at least for the duration. They've got some limitations. There's concern about the China agreement. There's the final steps that need to be taken on the USMCA, but those are giving us a little bit of footing here. For the recent months, we've had a divergence between consumer expectations and CEO expectations. Consumer expectations have been very positive. CEO expectations have been adverse. And what the CEO expectations seem to have been based on was this anxiety about trade. With the temporary lifting of that anxiety, we may all start heading in the same positive direction. And that, of course, would be positive for markets.
How big of an economic impact do you think we'll see, or how big of a boost will these trade deals, I guess, if they actually go through, we can call them the phase one deal at least, and the USMCA, how big of an impact do you think that will have on the economy?
Definitely positive. I think in terms of magnitudes, I would say modest. One of the issues that we have to keep in mind is that we seem to be bumping up on the ceiling in terms of U.S. employment. So the question is just how much headroom is there on the basis of these positive trade agreements? But that having been said, they are positive. They do lift a certain amount of anxiety. There's the possibility that they will have decision makers in business looking more positively towards potential investment, which would increase the capacity of the economy. And so it's a positive. I wouldn't oversell it, but the U.S. economy is capable of expansion, and we're looking forward to that, if at all possible.
Joe, what is your take on the trade deals that we did reach, the phase one with China and the USMCA? Do you think that the Trump administration was victorious in those?
The Trump administration wanted one big positive deal on China. They didn't get that. What we have seen is a willingness of China at least to come to some measure of an agreement. That's a positive. In exchange, the United States has rolled back some of its tariffs, has left some more in place. That may possibly provide some leverage going forward. It does suggest the potential for further agreement, but China has been a very difficult negotiating partner. We've gotten into a stage where you have the President of the United States, the head of the Chinese Communist Party, and the Chinese government in a kind of an arm wrestle here. Nobody wants to lose. It remains to be seen how much farther we can go. Victory yet? No, we've got too many remaining issues to resolve between the United States and China.
All right, Joseph Minarik, thanks for joining the show today.